We've all been there. A busy maternity unit. A rush of people arrive in triage. Who do you see first? You could see them in order of arrival. Or deal with simple things first to clear beds. But amongst those people waiting, there could be someone who's in serious need of urgent care, queuing for their turn. So how can you ensure your team provides prompt, efficient care to the right person? Let's look elsewhere. In emergency departments, a nurse triages each patient to determine their priority. This standardised assessment helps them decide whose needs are most urgent and the most effective way for the department to meet them. Maternity triage is the emergency portal for maternity services. The Birmingham Symptom-specific Obstetric Triage System, also known as BSOTS, is an evidence-based triage system recommended by the RCOG and CQC. It's designed to provide quick and effective assessment, resulting in safer, better care for pregnant and birthing people and their babies. It uses a standardised system to determine clinical urgency and onward care pathways. Care is divided into two stages to ensure appropriate, efficient treatment and smooth throughput of pregnant people. The first part is the initial triage assessment. Every attendee is seen by a dedicated triage midwife within 15 minutes of arrival for a prompt, brief, standardised assessment. This assessment should take no more than 5 to 10 minutes. It logs the arrival time and includes a maternal history, baseline observations, assessment of pain levels, abdominal palpation and auscultation, and the primary reason for attendance. This is selected from a list of the 8 most common reasons for attendance at maternity triage. Then, the BSOTS algorithm and the midwife's clinical assessment are used to allocate each pregnant person one of 4 clinical categories: red, orange, yellow, and green. All ongoing care is then provided by a different midwife. The roles of triage midwife and ongoing care midwives are separate, instead of one midwife being responsible for the full care episode. Although the triage midwife can assist with ongoing care where possible, the division of roles allows them to focus on completing initial assessments within 15 minutes for anyone attending triage. The immediate ongoing care is guided by the symptom-specific algorithm, which includes key timings based on the level of clinical urgency. Red is the most urgent. In this instance, the person should be transferred to the delivery suite and seen immediately. Orange requires ongoing care by a midwife within 15 minutes. People in this category would remain within the triage clinical area, but move to a different room to keep the triage space free for new arrivals. People categorised as yellow receive ongoing care by a midwife within an hour, whilst green would be seen within 4 hours. In both these cases, the person could return to the waiting area to keep the triage beds free. Whatever the category, any ongoing care is provided by different midwives, guided by the symptom-specific algorithm. Applied effectively in a protected and appropriate triage space, BSOTS results in safer care for pregnant people and their babies, improves communication and manages expectations, and it creates a more structured, less stressful working environment for staff. It also enables staff to have an overview of the whole department. How many people are in attendance? The clinical urgency of each person? And when each person will require further assessment. BSOTS makes providing safe and high-quality maternity care and triage easier for all staff. For more information about implementing BSOTS and how it can help you provide better, safer care, see the BSOTS website on Future NHS.